You're watching Uncle K Live TV.
Hi everybody, if you have come early, welcome. I don't mind. It's you're going to give me company till we start. I think from Dubai time perspective, it is still 9 minutes remaining, or maybe 10 minutes. I keep my watch a little bit fast because that helps me reach my appointments earlier than expected. Although it's a psychological thing, if I remember I put it fast, then I always minus the minutes I put it fast. But still, it's a good way of, I sometimes take it as the real time and try to reach wherever I'm going or whichever appointment, I'm always 5 minutes earlier. Because with my experience, with my life's experience, I've noted that things do not go always as you expect them. There will be hurdles, there will be tests. What happened to this? Nothing? I thought something happened. Okay. So, I am allowed to talk freely without any script and all, because now we have not started that officially. At 1 o'clock we will be starting. But since you are here, you can tune in, you can check your mic, you can check your audio and the camera, the video part. So this is the best time to do it. That's what we are also doing here. So don't mind these instructions and all, because my colleague cannot sit still. He's always fiddling with something. But I assure you that after one, he will be sitting still also, because he'll be behind another camera then. So let's introduce myself. That's the reason we hold these seminars, and we have appropriately named it as Face to Face with Uncle K. And before, sometimes I had also put a time for my videos, regular videos, and I named it Happy Hour with Uncle K. And I was really taunted by many people that, are you offering drinks or is it a bar? Why did you call it a happy hour? Happy hour means through any source, if I can give you happiness. Of course, my face is not that photogenic that just by looking at me, you'll feel happy. In fact, you may laugh at me because I look like a joker. And that also is a good part I'm doing. It's a good deed that I make people laugh for whatever reason. Although it's bad manners to laugh at somebody, but if you do at me, I don't mind. Keep laughing. If I can make you laugh, I am doing a good deed. I have a schedule to fulfill. Every day I count how many good deeds I have done. So making somebody laugh is okay, that's a better part, but even making somebody smile is a good deed. And if I smile at you, I'm doing it on purpose, because I feel happy amongst humans. Humans in my category are not the worst. These are just a clean slate. You can make them devils or you can make them angels. My target is to seek out the angel in you. I don't reject anybody, irrespective of their bad deeds or good deeds or their manners or their haughtiness or their pride, because I know we are all being controlled by different vibrations, by different strings, which is not in our control. We have to learn to distinguish between different type of behavior. So if you, for example, I'll give you compare it with a drunkard, a drug addict. If they are acting crazy, we know the reason. So our purpose is not to be angry at you, to be revengeful against you. Well, our purpose is to weed you off the intoxicant or the poison you are using, to bring you back to the humanity. It gives us, we get credit. It's a give and take, even with God, even with religion. Anywhere you go, there is give and take. Either you give or you take. So this way, we get more credit from God if we are doing something good for humanity. Now that you understand that, for example, let me tell you something. It's gone off. let me tell you something. You know about exorcism. In Catholicism, they have this thing they call exorcism. If somebody is possessed by the devil or the spirits, they have a way of carting those spirits away from that body. Suppose you meet somebody who is possessed by whatever spirit, bad spirit, devil. You don't shoot the person to get rid of the devil. Your purpose is to get rid of the devil to save the human. So now that you understand, this is what we do. This is what I will be doing. That is what my mission is. Okay, that is my mission. It's personal. Wow, how are you people involved in it? Why am I doing all this face-to-face, live videos? This is to bring people on board so that at least some people agree with me. You can become my member. You can join me. You can link with me on LinkedIn. You can join me on Facebook. You can send me encouraging comments on Twitter. Why? What you will say, what are we? How can we be make you so successful? What can we do with that? We are just ordinary human beings. This is what I want to specify, that no human being is ordinary. When you go to the theory, this is just an intro, so I'm not giving you all the details. You have to become my member. But when you go to the theory of vibrations, the theory of attraction, you must have gone through that, how to become rich, how to make things come to you, attract them. These are all vibrations. You have to have that happy, positive feeling, positive vibrations. And alone, if you are doing it, it's okay, it works. But the more people you connect with you, the more vibrations there are, the more powerful those vibrations are. You go to any religion in the world, old, live, present, any religion, I guarantee you, they will always specify that when you pray, every religion has a weekly praying day where everybody collects together. They call it a congregation. You pray together as one being and you pray. That prayer has a huge volume of vibrations because everybody's thoughts are on the same level, same vibrations, but stronger. So there is a chance that your wishes will be fulfilled when you are together. It should be positive, it should not be against anybody, it should not harm anybody, it should not be for selfish reasons, it should only be for the good of humanity. So when you join me, even if you are not watching each and every one of my broadcasts, when you become a member, I'll be inviting you at certain broadcasts, you will be there. That will be like you are praying with me together. By praying now, I'll give you another example of what I do so that you will know what you can expect from this. I do not believe in rituals. I will not tell you that you lift your hand like this and you pick your feet up or you do this or you do that, then only your prayer will be successful. No, prayer goes through your heart. Whether your hand is here or whether your hand is here, these are irrelevant. It has no value. So in some religions, they will catch you only by their ritual, that if you do this, then this thing happens. Or if you repeat this word, yes, repeating some word, positive words, I believe in that. It happens if you keep on repeating those words, because those are the vibrations, the positive vibrations. And what example I can give you, you can try it yourself at home. You must have heard, and maybe some of you must be laughing at the people who talk to their pets, who talk to their plants. People like you may be thinking that these people who talk to their plants, who talk to their pets are crazy. No, they are not. They are not crazy. In fact, they have the secret which you should also acquire. That talking are waves. These are waves which do form and affect. People have tried it. I'm not a scientist. I'm not a very PhD. I've only studied in the University of Hard Knocks. I've learned from hard experience. These people in Japan, in America, they have tried. What they have done is they have taken just plain water in a glass, and they wrote bad words on that glass, and they spoke those bad words on that glass of water. They froze it. Another glass, they used encouraging words, good words, beautiful words, praising that water. They had wrote those things on that glass, froze it. After 2 days, when they took out both the glasses, the one which had the bad words had a blackish, brownish color, and it was not forming as good ice. It was still in, crystals and all. The one which had the positive words was solid ice cube like a diamond. Same way with the plants. When you talk to them nicely, they grow very well. Try it. I'm not saying this from my experience. I've seen it online. So talking now, if this convinces you, imagine your words, how they affect another human being. If you curse somebody, if you say bad things to a human, you are destroying his will to live. And you could be a murderer, you could be charged as a murderer in the eyes of God. We are all God's creations. We are nobody to judge anybody. We are not better than anybody. We are not holier than the other person. Holiness, prayers, they have different meanings to different people. Remember, God has made people in a way that they do not imitate. You will not find the same fingerprint, copy of the same fingerprint in another human being. You will not find the iris as the same of another human being. You know these things. There is no duplicate in God's eyes. We are all individual, unique people. When you are talking to another human being, lowering his dignity, blaming that person, insulting that person, in other ways, you are raising yourself, your self-esteem, that you are better than that person. No. You never know what is in your future. You never know, that person could be better than you. Don't go for the now and here effect. Look at the future also. What can happen? Your direction you take today will affect your future tomorrow. You believe in luck. This is related to luck and all. You say luck gives you everything. I'll tell you how you can make your own luck. If you have patience, if you have belief, and you stick to your beliefs, you have to be strong. When you think, when you know you are right in what you are doing, that's your principle, you stick to it. Irrespective of whatever, the more you want to prove yourself to be strong, the more test will be thrown at you. This is the way the nature works. You say, I am close to God, the God will give you so much suffering that one day you will say, oh, okay, I give up. The more nearer you want to go to God, the more suffering will be thrown at you. You have to pass these tests to really prove that you are nearer to God. No human being can bear that suffering. God is not cruel, but you have to go through that acid test. Without test, you cannot even be a pious saint. Every person has to go ahead. Take history of any religion. All those saints had to suffer. All those people, all those messengers, they had the worst situation they had to face. They were alone. The whole nation were against them, but they survived because their principle was there, their patience was there. Once you know you are right, forget anything. Don't be afraid of death. What is death? Death is just a transition. You are going from one level to another level. The future is there. That is eternity, not this one. These place is just a classroom. I was giving you an example if I'm not boring you. I'll continue like this. If you want me to take a break, I'm sorry, this is a half an hour session. I will finish it and then you can do whatever you want to do. I was giving you an example. In one country, there was a family and the father died. The father had married second time. The first wife had died. So the first wife had one son. Then the second wife had three sons. The father died. They left them a lot of land. So what the mother did, she gave the fertile land, all the fertile land to her three sons. And one land was in the desert that she gave to the stepson. Now this is, I'm talking about my country when we had our capital in Karachi. Our capital was going to be shifted to Islamabad. And surprising, Islamabad has no sand at all. So what happened? This son did not say anything to her, his mother, kept serving her like an obedient son. Her own three sons started spending money lavishly, became drunk, did all the bad deeds, and finished all the wealth their father had. This son kept his land in the sand, the sandy land, and kept quiet and kept praying and serving his mother, stepmother. When Islamabad started building, they needed sand for construction. Without sand, you cannot build houses or anything. They had to go very far. Only this guy's land was the nearest. So the whole of the city was built by the sand from this guy's land. He became a billionaire. Nobody could build a house, they need sand. And if you bring it from far away places, the trucking and the transport cost is high. So he waited patiently. Why? Because he was on the right track. He was not blaming his mother. He was just taking it as his fate. If his mother had cheated him out of the land, he never thought it that way. He said, whatever she gives, she is my mother. Stepmother though, but she is my father's wife. I have respect for my elderly people. Never think that things are going bad. You are only going through a test and these are reactions. All your life is just reactions. Situations will be thrown at you and how you react. Don't go overboard. Don't lose your temper. Temper is the biggest poison that no doctor can cure or nobody can do it. You have to control your own temper. They say it is blood pressure and all the blood pressure does not come by itself. It is the cause of the temper. You have to control your temper, you will control your blood pressure. Now people will say you can do yoga, you can do this. Instead of that, go to the humanity, go to people when they are suffering, help them. You don't need yoga, this is your prayer. Whenever I find time, I do one thing which I'm surprised. I've met many religious organizations, whether they be Catholics, Christians. I've studied in a missionary school, so I've been very close to Catholicism also. I go to these organizations. Only one I liked and from whom I learned was Catholics. They have a habit, their fathers and their own. They go to hospitals. They go sit beside patients. Patients who have no relatives to comfort them. They do that religiously. This is as if it is their duty. I learn from them. So whenever I have time, I go and visit hospitals. Only thing the doctors warn me about, those who know me, that Khurshid, don't make them laugh too much. They have stomach stitches. If I'm sitting with a particular patient, they will warn me that don't make him laugh too much. Because that's the purpose I am there. Once they laugh, once they have a will to live again. Otherwise, they say, what's the use of living? We don't have any relatives. Nobody's there. Some of them are even worrying about the bill of the hospital. So try to arrange some funds for them. Have right contacts. Just give them the signal. There are societies here. There are Indian societies. There are Christian societies. Irrespective of any religion, call those people, they take over. All we do is to point out the right person for them. Believe me, there are some Indian societies, they even take those people, give them a ticket, and they send them back to their country. They pay all the hospital bills also. Not only hospitals, I visited jails here. There are jails, people are suffering just because they cannot pay a fine of 5,000 or 10,000 dirhams. And they are there in jail. They have to support their families. So we are not becoming angels by this. We are setting a standard even for the angels to look and follow, that we are humans and we can also do good deeds. Remember, that's why God created us, to prove to the angels that these people, these humans I am creating, can do bad things, can do good things. I have given them that willpower, but they will still go for the right. They will not do bad things. I think time is not over yet. This is what we do here. We have a TV, we have a radio. All the audio of this thing will be broadcast through our radio. The reason I am doing all these things, and my colleagues, my team is helping me with that, is I should be, and the good word should be accessible to each and every person, irrespective of their religion, country, their gender, their color, their sect, or whatever you call it, whatever tribe they are in. I have nothing to do with that. The radio, the TV will be broadcasting our words. We'll be trying to give you training. We have training courses. There are some free, some are paid. If you are already in some profession, my profession I'm teaching is customer service and English for tourism and all, so that if you know this, at least you'll get a decent job. Then we have a recruitment company where we, again, it is paid. We collect money for that because we train you and then recruit you. There also I give a lot of discount for deserving people. So join us, try to interact with us. The first proof I'll give you of my customer service habits are, I answer all my calls, I answer all my emails. Even if I am not in the office, I check my emails from home. So you are always in my radar. So don't worry, I will not forget. Only thing is, I don't like formalities because it wastes time. I'm only known as Uncle K. Call me K, don't say sir, don't say mister. And save time and write the main thing like a telegram. The main, highlight the point where the reason you are going to write to me or the reason you are calling me. Because I may be busy. If I'm helping you, I may be helping other people also. Some other people may be suffering, they need me urgently. So try to make it as short as you can and give me your details. Sometimes I may not be able to answer immediately. I have to go through it, I have to think about it. I may respond back maybe with the next day. The another thing which I do is, as you have read there, that I do face reading. I evaluate people by their faces. It's not spiritualism, as I have mentioned. I don't have any gift. I don't do clairvoyant. I don't do future studies from there. Only logical face study, I can tell you your aptitude, which profession you are fit for. Because if you are not happy in your profession, your life, it will always be suffering. It will make you a freak, a blood pressure, a gripey sort of guy, always cursing, always blaming others. One thing I'll tell you about blaming others, when you go and gripe to strangers and your family and your friends all the time about your troubles, believe me, they will be laughing at you inside. And they will be thinking they are lucky because they are better than you. Because you see, people laugh at others suffering, whether they are friends. This is human nature. So don't go complaining to each and everybody about your problems. People who are listening to you are thinking that they are better off than you because they don't have those problems. Then they will point out that maybe you are wrong, you are doing some mistakes. So don't go into that, because then when the opinions are coming from them, maybe one-sided, maybe self-interest, they may have self-interest, they will put you down more than you deserve. Because by putting you down, they grow up. They think they are going higher. Another thing that some people have a habit of giving their opinions. They may tell you also that you are not good at this, you are not good at that, you cannot do this. What, are you crazy? Why are you planning on doing that? Keep one rule in mind. Other people's opinions are not your business. Don't ever, ever concentrate on that. Except if you have a confidant, your mother, your father, who are sincere to you, if they tell you something, they may be 80% right. Here also, I'm not saying they are 100% right. Why 80%? They are your father and mother. They have given you birth. They have raised you. They know you, your nature, everything. But still 20% they don't know. Because every human is unique. What you know about yourself, even they don't. You cannot explain it to them that, no, I'm good at this. If I love, I like music, I want to do this, I want to do that. They may stop you from that. You do where your heart is. For if your profession is what you love, and that's what your profession is, and that's your hobby becomes your income, you are the happiest person in the world. Because then there is no difference between your house and your work. You know, happy people, if you're happy in your work and what you do, they forget the time. They don't even notice when they try to be early and they go off late. Even at home, they are dreaming and thinking about the work they are doing. They are on a high cloud. It gives you that high. And happy people have no health problems. You will never, never be the person standing in line in a medical center, going to a doctor. And the bad thing, I would say that many doctors are not like that, some of them are good. The bad thing is that the doctors will not tell you the cure. They cannot go into your life and tell you to change your style and change this thing and change. They will just prescribe medicines and all medicines have side effects also. One medicine will create two more diseases in you. One from the doctor's point, from the health caregiver's point, they are making money out of you. Why should they stop you from becoming sick? If they were so sincere, the whole world would be disease-free by now. You know, when they have a formula, they discover a new disease, and then they find a medicine, a cure for it, or an inoculation for it. They sell it in millions and billions of dollars, that formula. They are there to make money. Sometimes I wonder if these diseases are also not created by these pharmacists, these people who are making medicines. For example, virus. Antivirus companies may be creating the virus also, so that more of the antivirus is sold. I don't know, I'm not saying that, don't take me to court on that. But think of the human nature. This is how it is. Grabbing somebody else's food, grabbing somebody else's money, creating, and now who are these people who do these things? Where is the flaw? How do you distinguish between these people and the ones who are good? The reason why they are like that. These are the people who have lost faith in God, in their religion. They think that they themselves have to create this food. They themselves are going to feed their stomach. They've forgotten that there is a higher authority which has promised to give you your sustenance. You leave the sustenance to God. You do your good deeds. There is a saying in any, again, I challenge you, pick up any book, any religion. There is a saying in all of them. You spend in God's way 10 dirhams, He will return 70 dirhams back to you before you leave this world. God does not like loans. God does not like credit from humans. He will not only give you 70 dirhams back in this world, He will also make arrangements for you in the hereafter. For example, you have only 10 dirhams in your pocket, you are hungry, you are going to sit for lunch, you don't know where your next meal is going to come, you are planning to spend only 3 dirhams, and you see somebody sitting with next to you who's only drinking a glass of water, he has no money to take lunch. You offer your lunch to him, you share it with that guy. You think nothing happens before this? It goes unrewarded. You do it, try it every day, every day, every day, and see the way it comes back to you. Doors open, you go for an appointment, for an interview, they hire you immediately. When you are passing the road, even strangers sometimes say, hello, hi, how are you? Your vibes, that positiveness oozes out of you. It's like people walking near a flower garden and you walk by a bush of roses. You not even notice the roses, but when that aroma, that bouquet, that smell comes to you, you praise God, ah, what a nice smell. Same way if a positive person passes by you, you just feel lifted and you want to shake the hand of that guy if you can stop that person. Maybe he's busy or passing away. But you look out for such people. These people, when they come, you know that they are there for a purpose. If you know, get the company of such people, your things will be answered, your prayers will be because they will put you on the right track. Your vibration need tuning. I don't know what's the time. I think we have still 7 minutes, but I'd like to take your leave to end this little bit earlier. If those who are watching online would like to interact, ask me any question. We are on Twitter. We are there. In your, next to your video, there is a chat thing. You can press that. I will see your chats. And let's make this a question and answer session. And if I get any question, I'll answer. Thank you very much.